riding my horse one day, I had a flash and I heard him say, "It's more than leather that you hold."
Hey Regina, we're just going to talk a little bit today about EquiPride. We're at your barn. I don't know what y'all call your farm, just Bond Farms or whatever, and a Regina Bond training farm. But we're just going to talk a little bit today about EquiPride and what you've seen and some of the differences and horses that are on it and not on it.
The product works on ulcers. It has your probiotics to help, helps with abscesses, tying up, healing and promoting healing of torn tissue, muscles. Right now we have a horse, QT, our pole horse, she's tore a deflexor, and when we went, it was a 48 centimeter tear.
Mm-hmm.
2.5 weeks we went back, and remind you, she's on the lick and 4 scoops of the top dressing, and she went aggressively on the lick from the time she tore it after that rodeo. We went back for our exam, and he was real quiet, ultrasounding and measuring it and looking, and then he gave me his diagnosis, and he said that it was unreal, that she was over halfway healed. It was down to 24, and that was unreal for 2.5 weeks. By textbook and in the vet world of their knowledge and what they've been taught, that's not supposed to happen.
Wow.
So we've obviously got a lot of blood flow going through there, and obviously she's smart enough to know she needs to be on that lick because she's staying on it very regular right now. And that's the only thing that we can all pinpoint that she's on that's promoting that healing that aggressively and that quickly.
It helps her with her water intake. She's not ever been one that was real good about drinking when you hauled her.
Mm-hmm.
And after you ran her, you'd know she'd be thirsty. But once she went on the top dressing and the lick, she would drink unlimited water throughout the day while we were there competing. So I know that made a big difference, and as we all know, if our horses don't get enough water intake, they dehydrate. Or they can get impacted, and mm-hmm. then we fight colic. Also with this mare, she's quit tying up, and you know, if we do have a battle, it may be once a year where it used to be so frequent that she knows that she was tying up and she would stop in the arena and practicing, and we'd have to stop, pull saddle off, and
wait untied.
And she would walk off when she untied. Hmm. So it's made a huge difference there. All of it goes back to blood flow. We had a very hot summer, and you know, I was very blessed. We didn't have any colics. We didn't have any problems with any dehydrating. I didn't have any turning into breathing problems like we've heard. And a lot of people around here had horses that quit sweating. None of mine quit sweating. But once again, I'm on a very good product that helps keep everything very balanced. Also with the roping mare, she's trying to fuse right now, and she's 8 years old, and in her fusion, the vet has said that he has never seen one fusing as smoothly and as much bone nice and neat and quickly there. It's balanced her disposition a whole lot more.
Right.
Plus it's helped with that pain factor that she's going through. As we all know, fusing is the most painful time for a horse till they get through that. I just have such a bloom on these horses that I've never had before, and I stay consistent with this product.
Right.
And through all the stress of hauling them every weekend place to place, or whether it's just riding and training them here, they seem to be handling everything and recovering quicker.
Right.
Where when you're exercising, just like you or I, we tear down muscle, so we have to build back up muscle.
When you take the reins, you know.
Have several in your barn that you've just gotten in here and that you've gotten started on it that people claim they can't get on the product. So give me a little bit of, tell me how you do that. How do you accomplish getting these horses on there?
Well, Kathy, I have had some that have come in that they have tried the product, they couldn't get it on, so they weren't a believer in it like I am because I've been on a year and 4 months. But I've learned that if there is one that will not accept this product, they obviously must have a stomach issue going on. And so they're scared to try the product for the fear of what the acid's going to do in their stomach, and it's going to tear it up and get them all feeling bad. So therefore they don't want to try something new. But what I've learned to do is if I have a horse that's real hard to get on it, then I just start Maloxanum, which coats that stomach, and I've done it as much as 3 times a day and 30 cc's. Well, that starts working on the stomach, and then that makes it easier for them to accept the EquiPride. And I have horses here that clients have swore they wouldn't eat it. They wouldn't. They've had the lick. They've bought it from you. They wouldn't. And now they're on top dressing and lick, and I've seen them grazing in the pasture, the ones that are in the pasture, and stop, come lick if they need it, and they stay on their water. And so I've had success with it, but I think it's all the secret is getting that horse stomach soothed and started so that he can start on a product that does help him. I had a horse come in that wouldn't even eat his own feed that they were feeding him. Right. Now he's eating, he was eating theirs, and then we converted him to mine, which had was 12% high oat, and I add some rice bran to it, and I give it 4 scoops of EquiPride, and it never leaves a drop behind, and it doesn't go in there and eat, whether he's in the field eating or whether he's in his stall eating. He doesn't take a bite, go to the corner now, think about, well, do I want to go back over there and have a bite? From the time he starts eating, he's there with his head in that trough till he's finished to the bottom, slick clean. I've seen him lick it. So I believe firmly in the product that I've seen where it's more than just something that you put in that feed that's gonna get them to drink in some water. And I just feel like I've seen bloom in their weight, hair coat. They stay on the water, whether it's real cool or, and where a lot of horses back off, mine have not backed off. I continuously have to top off buckets, even with this little cool spell we've had coming through. I thought, well, they'll back off. They have not backed off their water right now. So they didn't last winter when we had snow on the ground and frozen pipes. I was fretting, and they
which
were
is not like Mississippi weather
right,
at all.
Right.
Yeah, we don't get snow often.
A lot of people were fretting with colic, and knock on wood, I didn't have the first one to colic, but they're all on the top dressing, and about half of them here are on the lick.
Tell me about your EPM mare that you had that you got started on EquiPride. Boy, don't we wish we'd had EquiPride when we knew they were sick, yeah. You know.
Well, I didn't realize this mare had EPM. I think it was underlying when I purchased the mare, and the more we brought her out and got to working her, it just was recurrent. It mm-hmm. was dormant laying there. Once you convinced me to get started on EquiPride, she was one of the first horses that I had put on it. Mm-hmm. She was on top dressing and a lick immediately. And within 2 weeks, I saw differences. Not only in hair coat, she lost that bellied look that they get with EPM. She started gaining weight over her hips. Her coordination was much better. She's not back where this mare used to be, but she is very much more coordinated, can handle 3 turns snappy. She looks like a horse again.
Right.
If somebody walked up to her, they would not know that she had been affected by EPM. And you can tell if, like one time I went off the lick some with her and just kept the top dressing only. I think the lick and the top dressing together are very powerful. They mm-hmm. they reinforce either, because that horse knows when they need something more than what we're giving them. So
right.
they go to the lick. And then sometimes they're aggressive and sometimes they're not. But I have seen the difference with her on and off as far as the shape of her body and over her hips and her coordination.
Now, on we're talking about Flash for just a second. This is your personal horse mm-hmm. that you've had for a long time. Mm-hmm. He was in an injury, if I'm not mistaken, mm-hmm. several years ago. Mm-hmm. And since then, you've had him, and he started on the lick.
Mm-hmm.
And tell us what we've seen since him being on that lick.
Well, through his injury, his stifle healed correctly. Mm-hmm. But he also is fusing, and he's been a slow fuser. And as well as that, he had some other issues from the injury that went on with him that I wasn't real sure how, if I could get him back and going.
Right.
Had him on the EquiPride, the lick. He's one that he's been on and off of it. He doesn't just steadily stay on it. I can tell that he utilizes it when he needs it.
Mm-hmm.
The more we're riding him now and getting him back going, I see him on it more than if he's just kind of out. So that tells me that when we're riding him with his issues, he's needing something to help.
Right.
So that's when
right.
he's going to it. If he's not, then he's just moderate on the lick.
Right.
So right now with his fusing, we've seen it change. We've seen bone density change in him. Much smoother. The vet has been amazed at what all has happened with him, because that is all he is on, is the top dressing and the lick, because he has been hurt. And with Bobby Lynn Rodeo, and they're trying to keep all the rodeo horses going and
right.
on their top of their game. He's not been the top of the list, but right now he's headed back going that direction. I had gotten real sick, and prior to that I did get to make a run on him, and for 6 years this horse refused the gate forward motion. I'd have to step on him, roll him, and go. And for the first time, he went face forward into the pen without a balk or a refusal. So that tells me EquiPride must be helping him in his pain relation of some things that I didn't realize that were going on with him that's making him want to go perform again.
Right.
So we're back conditioning him and getting him going.
It isn't some kind of magic.
We've got John Dean talking to us today, me and Regina and Bobby Lynn. And we're just kind of wanting to see, John, what have you seen as in horses that are on EquiPride versus the ones that are not on EquiPride with their hoof growth, with anything like that? What can you tell us that you've seen the big differences?
The biggest thing that I've seen, especially with horses that I have been working on, and then the changes that I have seen after they've been on the EquiPride, is the amount of hoof growth and the density of the hoof wall. It's changed a whole bunch, and the growth pattern changes. Even the depth of their soles have changed, especially your thoroughbred type horses have really improved. That's what I've seen.
And you just, I mean, they're just, they grow better. They, of course, you're having to visit them a lot.
Yes.
More.
Right. You can tell, especially during the warmer months when they grow faster, you're getting a whole lot more growth. But what I'm seeing is the hoof is more pliable.
Mm-hmm.
You'll have a horse that has more of a grainy texture to their hoof wall. And within, I'm going to say, usually like a month to 2 months is really when you see it. After that first shoeing and then through that next shoeing, you can tell a difference. What I have seen is the graininess seems to go away. It's almost like some of the horses, the texture of their hooves is like fiberglass. Real poor quality, the nails don't clench well, and within that couple of months you can really tell a difference. And it's kind of amazing, really, to me. I really didn't think something like that would work, but it does.
And you're not a big fan of supplements,
no,
are you?
No, I just figured if they're eating good, they're going to get what they want. But a lot of people don't realize that a hoof wall, all it is bound hair.
Mm-hmm.
And you see these horses that have kind of looked a little, well, they don't look as fleshy. When they start getting on this product, you can just tell a difference in their hair coat, and you really see it in their feet. So overall, the horses that I have seen that are on it, especially when they didn't look so good, they were healthy, but they just didn't have that fullness. And then whenever their feet start looking better, that's when I really started paying attention.
And some of the problem horses, say you've had a horse that, you know, my mare, for instance.
Right.
She went through the stress of a surgery not long ago. You just
right.
did her feet about
right.
2 weeks ago.
Yes.
And you even told me that they still looked really good.
They looked good. She was into her shoeing. We did her right at 6 weeks. And what I was really surprised, because I'd worked on the mare for a while, and then whenever she went through that transition stage, I had not seen her for a while. But the biggest thing that I noticed was the amount of healthy heel that this mare had grown and was able to maintain.
Right.
And that's what I liked, and that's kind of was what I was always wanting to see in this mare. And then after seeing this, and after this mare had been on this product, I was a little surprised, because I didn't think it was going to change her that much.
Right, right.
And when we did her the other day, I could really tell a difference. They seem to get over the abscesses quicker, so it must be internal.
Mm-hmm.
And once they get over them, the area that had abscessed and it popped out, whether at the top or at the bottom, it seems to heal quicker. You know, a lot of times they're really sore in the area on the sole of their foot where that's been either removed or it popped out on its own. And when you come back after that horse is over the lameness of the abscess, it seems like that new sole behind it is thicker than it normally would be.
A lot of times, so the healing time to you is a lot cut in half?
Right. It's almost odd because you almost have like a false sole. When that abscess heals, the horse is back sound again. You know that you're still going to be dealing with that area when you come back. And when I have come back to those that have had abscesses and you pare that foot just a little bit, the sole, the new sole that's coming back, has a lot more integrity to it than the ones that I've seen in the past did.
So it's like, let's just say this product gets the bad out so the good can come in?
It must. It must be because you can see it after they've been on it for a while. I know there's nothing instantaneous.
Right. It takes time.
But you can tell the ones that are on it, the horses here at this place, I'm really impressed on how I'll watch them while I'm here shoeing. My favorite horse that's here, I'll kind of peek out at her, and she'll go in and rest a while, and she'll come out, and she stays on that lick. So you know instinctively that horse is needing that in its system.
Right.
And it works. It works.
Well, John, we appreciate you stopping here today and visiting with us. And
you bet.
I guess I'll see you at my house next week.
You bet.
All right.
Thank you.
Thanks, John.
Okay.
It just does my heart good to hear these stories. These people who've had horses that they really care about their horses, but they've tried everything and they're down to their last means and they don't understand, and then they try this product and then they're just amazed. And you know, I'm grateful to y'all for y'all trying the product again.
Well,
you know,
we've enjoyed it and our horses obviously do.
Yeah.
And I had a horse that came in back in May also. I'd been riding the mare. Everything's been going really well. She'd had a fracture, so we had put her on the lick and the top dressing because the fracture was healed, but I didn't want to stress everything
right
in the riding. In 2 weeks, this mare started going off on her right really bad. She was okay, like on a Friday she was off, on a Monday she was good. Then she went off on the left bad. I couldn't figure out what was going on. I thought, oh gracious, we're back to the fractured leg.
Right.
Well, went to the vet. There was the fracture, all that was good. Immediately what he had found was two bad abscesses, one in each back, which was unreal. And he said, he even x-rayed just to make sure we had no damage, and said that he could not believe those were dormant abscesses laying there and had been there for a while. And probably when we started her on the lick, they started moving, but then she went off. And then when I put her on it, she went very aggressive in 2 week period of time, half of a lick. And so obviously that lick and the top dressing together, because she'd never came off the top dressing, was much more powerful,
right,
and brought the abscesses to a head. And also John, who you spoke with earlier, saw her and looked at the abscesses himself when we got her back here, and he didn't know what the vet had said, and he said the same thing. Those have been there for a long time. They're channeled very deep, and it had to be the EquiPride that brought them to a head to come on out and get this mare comfortable. So
right,
we've done nothing but see good things.
Animal and man, more than a word or a whisper.
EquiPride enhances everything that you're doing with your horse to utilize it
right, better.
And you can do it too if you put your heart in your hand.